So lumbar lordosis is when there is an excessive arch in the spine like that. I don't know if you can see it. Is it visible?
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is lumbar lordosis and this is kyphosis of the thorax. Okay. So this is that hunch. So you can have somebody who's got excessive lumbar lordosis, and instead of, so when you do excessive lumbar lordosis, you end up looking at the sky. But most of your action takes place at eye level, so you have got to do this. So now you have excessive lumbar lordosis and excessive thoracic kyphosis, and you have that very prominent S-shaped spine. What you need to do is a long spine, and for that you need to get rid of this excessive curvature and get a flat spine. And then if you flatten the spine, you are also going to get a less hunched over thoracic spine. Now all of this will start from the hip.
Yeah.
Because when you do an excessive lumbar lordosis, what is happening is your pelvis goes tilting forward like that. You are going to tilt the pelvis backwards and make the pelvis level. So your waistband should be level and horizontal to the floor instead of pointing downwards. The front of it is usually pointing downwards. So fix your pelvis and the rest of it goes up. If you want to go deeper, it starts from the feet. So if most of your weight is in the front of your feet, your pelvis is going to dump forwards, and this is going to have your back arch backwards, and then you're going to have to end up, this is the standard position of somebody who's used to working in an office. So if you put more of your weight back into the heels or slightly into your midfoot, if you stack it properly, you will end up with a neutral pelvis, a neutral spine, and a neutral thorax, and then your posture gets better. So I'll show you the poor posture again, and this, all it required was shifting my weight from front to my heels or to the midfoot, and then the posture gets better.